Brian again, and it is time for the types of fats. So in this video, we are going to discuss the four major types of fats, foods that are high in each of those types of fats, and whether or not each of those types of fats are healthy or unhealthy. So let's roll. So what are the different types of fats? There are two general types, saturated fats and unsaturated fats. Unsaturated fats have three different subtypes, trans fats, monounsaturated fats, and polyunsaturated fats. To understand fats better, we need to start with the main form of fat, which is triglycerides. Triglycerides consist of a glycerol unit and three fatty acid chains. Fatty acids are made up of long chains of carbon atoms and hydrogen atoms. Some carbon atoms are linked by single bonds and others by double bonds. These bonds determine which type of fat the chain is classified as. The first type of fat we're going to look at is saturated fat. In saturated fat, all of the carbon atoms are saturated with hydrogen atoms and do not contain double bonds between the carbon atoms. This gives the molecule a linear formation. Saturated fats are usually solid at room temperature and have high melting points. Foods that are high in saturated fat include pork, fatty beef, cheese, whole milk, eggs, coconut and palm oils, and butter. The question is, are saturated fats healthy? Research suggests that saturated fat affects cholesterol levels by increasing overall LDL, increasing HDL, and increasing LDL particle size. You can learn more about cholesterol by checking out my cholesterol video, which is linked in the little I in the right-hand corner of your screen. The American Heart Association recommends limiting saturated fat intake to 5 to 6% of total daily caloric consumption. So according to that recommendation, if you're consuming 2,000 calories per day, no more than 120 calories should come from saturated fats. That's about 13 grams, which is two slices of cheddar cheese. I must note that there is a lot of research linking diets high in saturated fat to heart disease, and there's a lot of research showing that claim not to be true. As with any food, it's always about moderation. Now let's look at unsaturated fats. Unlike unsaturated fats have at least one double-bonded set of carbon atoms in their structure. This double bond can take on one of two formations. It can be a cis configuration or a trans configuration. In the cis formation, the hydrogen atoms are on the same side of the double-bonded carbon atoms, and in the trans formation, the hydrogen atoms are on opposite sides. Let's take a look at the trans configuration, or trans fatty acid. Trans fats are solid at room temperature and usually have a high melting point. There are natural and artificial trans fats. Natural trans fats, also known as ruminant trans fats, typically make up 2 to 5% of the fat in dairy products and 3 to 9% of the fat in beef and lamb. Several review studies have concluded that a moderate intake of ruminant trans fats does not appear to be harmful. Artificial trans fats are another story. Artificial trans fats are formed when manufacturers turn liquid oils into solid fats through a process called hydrogenation. Hydrogenation is a process by which vegetable oils are converted to solid fats simply by adding hydrogen atoms. Hydrogenation increases the shelf life and flavor stability of foods. Foods high in artificial trans fats include many fast food items, some baked items like cookies and cakes, frozen pizzas, some coffee creamers, fried foods, and stick margarines. So, again, the question is, are artificial trans fats healthy? Research suggests that diets in artificial trans fats affects cholesterol levels by increasing overall LDL and decreasing HDL. It is also linked to an increased risk of heart disease. Trans fats are believed to cause damage to the inner lining of blood vessels as well. In November 2013, the U.S. Food and Drug Administration made a preliminary determination that partially hydrogenated oils are no longer generally recognized as safe in human food. Many institutes recommend completely eliminating artificial trans fats from the diet. Keep in mind that products can be listed as 0 grams of trans fats if they contain 0 grams to less than 0.5 grams of trans fat per serving. You can also spot trans fats by reading ingredients lists and looking for the ingredients referred to as partially hydrogenated oils. The next unsaturated fat we're going to look at is monounsaturated fat. It has a cis molecular formation where the hydrogen atoms are on the same side. This gives it a bend or kink-like formation. Monounsaturated fats have only one carbon double bond in their molecule. They're usually liquid at room temperature and have lower melting points than saturated and trans fats. Foods that are high in monounsaturated fat include many plant-based oils such as olive oil, canola oil, and peanut oil. Other foods include avocados and many types of nuts and seeds. So, are monounsaturated fats healthy? They are thought of as generally being good for health, especially when chosen over saturated or trans fats. But it's always about moderation. Any fat can be unhealthy when consumed in unreasonably high quantities. The last type of fat on our list is polyunsaturated fat. It also has a cis molecular formation. Again, the hydrogen atoms are on the same side, also giving it a kinked formation. Polyunsaturated fats have more than one unsaturated carbon double bond in their molecule. They're typically liquid at room temperature, but start to turn solid when chilled. Polyunsaturated fats are generally classified by their omega numbering. The omega carbon is the carbon atom at the end of the hydrocarbon chain. There are four types of omega fatty acids: 3, 6, 7, and 9. These are determined by where the location of the first double-bonded carbon atom is located. The fatty acid on the screen is an omega-3 fatty acid because the first double bond occurs at carbon number 3. The other omega fatty acids follow this same structure. The omega-3 and 6 fatty acids are considered essential because the body cannot make these. Foods high in omega-6 fatty acids include processed vegetable oils, salad dressings, fried foods, and grain-fed beef. Foods rich in omega-3 fatty acids include flax seeds, walnuts, salmon, and tuna. So, are polyunsaturated fats healthy? Research suggests that omega-6s can have inflammatory effects, and omega-3s can have anti-inflammatory effects. So, the ratio of these fats has been shown to be important. A ratio of 4 to 1, omega-6 to omega-3, or lower, has shown to decrease inflammation and lower the risk of other diseases. The average American diet currently has a ratio of 16 to 1. Once again, it's about moderation.
Bottom line time. Quick review, folks. Saturated fats, typically you want to minimize those in your diet. Artificial trans fats, keyword there is artificial, not natural. You want to try to eliminate those from your diet. Monounsaturated fats, generally thought of as being healthy, as long as you're getting them from a good source that's been minimally processed. And polyunsaturated fats, again, generally healthy, get them from a good source. You may want to keep an eye on your omega-6 to omega-3 ratios on the polyunsaturated fats. All right, if you have any questions, comments, you can leave them below. If you like the video, hit the thumbs up. If you feel that I have completely wasted a few minutes of your life, I gracefully apologize to you. You can exact some instant revenge by pounding that thumbs down and giving me my punishment. It's all good, man. It is all good. Till next time, I'm out. See ya.